Hello guys, it's Random Stuff Friday here, back with another video. So before proceeding towards the actual video, I'll show you something. This is a flip key which I ordered from Biker's Edge for my Dominar. If you want to purchase this kind of key, I will give the link in the description box below. Bikes like Benelli come with this kind of key. So yeah, if you want to purchase this, I will leave a link in the description box. So yeah, let's begin with the video. So in today's video, I will show you how to make this. Now you will be thinking, what the hell is this? So yeah, let me tell you, this is a switchback circuit which I made for my Activa. Now, those who don't know what a switchback circuit is, I will tell them what's the use of this switchback circuit, and those who actually know what a switchback circuit does, they can skip the video ahead for the procedure on how to make this. So actually the video procedure which I am going to show you is a pretty old video. Actually I had made it when I was not even having a YouTube channel. But now I am installing a light on my Activa for which this switchback circuit will be helpful. Now let me tell you what a switchback circuit is. Actually a switchback circuit is a switch which helps you to switch between two lights. For example, in higher end cars like Audi and BMW, they have a DRL installed in the headlights, which works as an indicator as well. So to switch between the white DRL and indicator, this switchback circuit helps. I searched online a lot to purchase this kind of switchback circuit, but there wasn't any switchback circuit online, so I had to make it myself. So the components which you will need to make this switchback circuit, I will write it in the description box below. You have to purchase it from offline market, because if you purchase this from online market, it will be very costly for you. So yeah, let's begin.
The use of switchback circuit is that when the headlight is on, only the white LEDs will turn on, and when you switch on the indicators, that time the white light will turn off and amber light will glow. I have to make this on my own because I searched online for many circuits, but ready-made was not available. So in this video I'm gonna show you how to make this type of switchback circuit for your dual tone or a dual color LED lights. This circuit can be used in two wheelers or even in cars as well. For this you will need some components, which are 12 volt PCB relay. You will get this in many colors, like this one is orange. You can get in blue color or also in black color, but the working is same. You will have 5 pins on this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this one. Then one more thing which you will need is 25 volt 4700 microfarad capacitor. Another thing which you will need is IN4007 resistor or diode. These things are very cheap. For making this one circuit, it will cost you around maximum 100 rupees. And I am using a circuit board PCB because I want this to be sturdy. I bought this circuit board and cut it two pieces from here. Like this. And one switchback circuit is already made by me. Now I will show you how to make the, what's the wiring diagram for this. I will provide this in description box below, but still I will show you once. See, this is 12 volt PCB relay. This is your IN4007 resistor. This is your 25 volt 4700 microfarad capacitor. And I am making this for my bar and legs. So see it properly. One more thing which you have to note is that on this IN4007 resistor, there will be marking here in grey color. That's your positive side. And even in this capacitor, the negative side will be marked like this. This is the negative side, this is the positive side. So these are the 5 pins. You will have 3 wires in bar and led. The black color one is your ground. Red color one is your amber, I mean indicator. And white color wire is your white DRL. Now in this relay, this pin is normally open. This pin is normally closed. And this is your common, which will get power supply. Everything is mentioned clearly here. Sorry, do the wiring accordingly. From the bar and light, your white wire, means white DRL wire, will get connected on normally open. Then the amber one, which is your red color wire, will get on normally closed. Then on the middle pin here, on the downward side, you will get connected to your 12 volt power supply, not on your battery but on ignition switch. Means if your moped is or a bike is BS4, when your headlight stays on when you turn on your engine. And one more thing, 12 volt DC supply is needed, means battery power is needed for this. So ignition connector, from that you can give connection here, or even directly from your headlight. The next thing, on this right hand side pin, you have to solder this like this, positive side upwards. And on the next side, you have to solder the positive side of your capacitor. After that, the negative side should be directly connected on the left hand side. Then the next thing which you have to do is, after you solder everything, solder two wires like this, two wires from which the positive side will go to your indicator positive terminal, and the negative side will get connected to your indicator negative terminal. That's all for this wiring. Now I will make another switchback circuit and show you how it's done. One circuit is already ready, and I have used 3 wires on this side, 2 wires on this side. This is your capacitor, this is your relay, and this is your resistor. And as you can see, this is your positive side of capacitor and positive side of your resistor which is there connected here, and I bridged it here, and the orange wire is for your indicator positive terminal. This red wire will get connected to ignition switch, and another wire which is brown color, which this will get connected to your indicator negative terminal. And this is the 12 volt relay. White wire is for your bar end light, white DRL, and the black one is for your amber one. Now I will show you the working of this switchback circuit. One more thing, if you buy resistor with more capacity, like this is 4700 microfarad, the time delay will increase between white and amber. I will show you now in a second. Okay, so see now, this is my 12 volt power supply, and the red wire which is common from this relay is connected to the positive terminal ignition switch. This orange one is your indicator one. This one is your ground, which is connected to the black wire or ground of your vehicle. From this bar end light, the black wire which is your ground is connected to the ground itself. Then this red one from the bar end light is your amber light, which is connected to the black wire on this switchback circuit, and the white one is connected to the white one, which is your white DRA. Now let's check this. As you can see now, the white amber LED is glowing now. White LED is glowing now. When you will turn on your indicator, see, it turned to orange. And when you leave it or switch off your indicator, it will turn back to white. See, indicator on, indicator off, and within 3 or 4 seconds it will turn back on to white DRL. This depends on your capacitor. If your capacity of your capacitor is more than 4700 microfarad, then the delay or gap between switching will increase. The lesser gap, the more gap or delay between switching. And resistor is mandatory while doing this circuit, because if you don't add a resistor here like IN4007, then the power which will charge this capacitor will again get transferred to this relay, and this can blow your relay. So resistor is necessary. This resistor will prevent the capacitor from transferring the power supply again to the relay. That's how you make this switchback circuit.
Okay, so as you saw the procedure how to make the switchback circuit, before commenting anything negative about this video, I will tell you again that this video was recorded by me sitting long away. So please don't comment any negative things on this video, because I wasn't prepared that time much as I am now. So yeah, if you like the video, please leave a like, share this video so that it can be helpful for others as well, and comment your views, and even subscribe to my channel. I have made a Facebook page and I have an Instagram account, so follow me there if you have any queries related to bike modifications and four-wheeler modifications. And even this switchback circuit will be useful for not only for two wheelers but even for four wheelers. So yeah, that's all for this video. Ride safe, be safe, don't be a stupid.